Hi, this is Nico from Q-Tools, and today I want to show you how, with our Quantenkoffer, we can perform a simple experiment showing graphically the nature of entanglement. And for this, I have set up everything. I have aligned the Quantenkoffer, and we have it such that one photon of a pair of photons is going through this periscope over the board over here, entering this periscope. And another photon of the same pair is going this direction on this downside beam path. And then over here, you can see the count rates we actually register when both of the photons hit a detector. With this one, we have entanglement in the polarization degree of freedom, which means we want to measure polarization. For this, we have these tokens, these modules that we can insert at this spot in the beam path, and in here is just a polarizer more or less, and we can set this polarizer to different angles and compare the count rate that we measure of the different angles with the count rate we measure at another angle. And first, let me show you that if we put two polarizers in one beam path, we can use the first polarizer to set a specific polarization that we then can measure with the second one. So to measure polarization, you would need to measure at different angles. So for example, you can turn this by hand and you will see that the count rate will change depending on the angle I set here. So you have to do this and you can see, you can lock on to the maximum and see which angle you actually are. And this will be the angle of the first polarizer with which we set the polarization. But instead, I can also touch this polarizer and set it to rotate on its own. And we'll also see this kind of fringes here. And we also have another method of seeing that, which is down here in the bottom left quadrant, where I just have to configure the view in the correct way, such that we now can, in this polar plot, we can set the angle of this polarizer as the angle of the polar plot, and the radius of the polar plot will be the count rate. So in this case, you can, with one brief view of this display, you can see that there are a lot of counts in this direction and almost no counts in this direction, which means that, of course, this polarizer is set to this direction over there. So I can now show you what happens if I turn this. I can turn this by 90 degrees, for example, and we'll get the figure of 8 in the other direction. I can also turn this to 45 degrees and we'll get the figure of 8 in the 45 degrees. So this is nothing to wonder about. That's just this polarizer leaves photons through with a specific polarization, and this polarizer measures that polarization, which is set by the first polarizer. But now what we can do is we have one photon here, and we have another photon here that actually belongs to the same pair. So if we now put this polarizer down here in the other beam path, and again use the same method to set in this polar diagram, we see again a figure of 8 arising. And again, I can turn this polarizer to a specific angle, which I will then measure at the other side on the other photon. So this shows that somehow what I do on this photon down here has an effect on the other photon up here, because the polarization of the other photon up here is measured differently depending on which angle I set on the polarizer at the bottom.